This video is all about LFOs and beginning to understand how they work, what they are, and what they do. A lot of people get confused by low frequency oscillators, or LFOs for short, but the easiest way to understand them is simply that, like regular oscillators, they are waveforms with shapes that move up and down. Imagine a sawtooth wave and the way that it rises and falls. But the difference between oscillators and low frequency oscillators is that whereas oscillators themselves make the sound, which is then shaped in various other ways, what LFOs do is to operate in the background. Rather than actually making a noise, they simply provide a shape. And that shape can be channeled into other parts of the synthesizer to create movement like vibrato or wah. Here's a basic synth sound that I've built in the ESP. Now what I want to do is to get this sound moving using vibrato and then wah, and you can see that within the ESP there's a dial that's going to let me create one or the other. I can either have vibrato or wah, and what these will do is to get the ESP's built-in LFO working on the sound for me. So the first thing I'm going to try is some vibrato. I'm going to grab the relevant dial and turn it around a little bit to the left to let in a little bit of vibrato. The further away I get from the central zero position, the more vibrato there'll be. So that's just a little bit added there. And underneath, I can set the speed. So you can see what happens if I open up a little bit more vibrato, you can hear that wobble. And you can also hear the variation if I modify the speed control. Let's open up some more vibrato now. Okay, so we move from the realms of a sort of subtle musical vibrato into kind of police car sirens and laser zaps and that kind of stuff, all of which is achieved with LFOs. So that's a waveform being routed into the oscillator section. Let's look at wah now. What this does is exactly the same thing, but it routes the LFO into the filter section this time. So we're not going to get pitch wobble, but tone wobble instead. Let's have a listen to that. So this time, rather than the pitch changing, our sound moves from bright to dull, and bright to dull, and backwards and forwards, and it's particularly effective on white noise. Listen to this. So we can create kind of helicopter sounds here, or the sounds of the seashore, if you like, as well. So that's how the LFO works in the ESP, either controlling pitch or tone. Now here's a basic sound that I've built in the ES1, and let's have a look at how it works with low frequency oscillator. You can see the LFO section down here, and you can see that I can pick a target and a rate for the LFO work that I want to do. So I've chosen pitch, so we're going to get vibrato. Here is the speed for it. And there's the result. And because the shape is a ramp up and down, it works in exactly the same way that the ESP was working before. However, there are various things that I can do here. For a start, I can change the waveform. So that's a down ramp. And an up ramp with variable speed. And here's the square wave option. As I lessen the amount, the notes get closer together. And you can also hear that there are random waveforms as well, which are great for creating sample and hold effects. So let's change the target to cutoff. So this time, rather than affecting pitch, we're going to be affecting brightness again. And we'll drag the cutoff point down a little bit. And again, increase the amount and slow down the rate. I can even sync the rate so it's in time with my track. Let's select 16th notes here. And now my random waveform is in time with my track at 120 beats per minute. So LFOs, remember, they're oscillators too, but what they do is to produce an output which can be channeled into the pitch section or the filter section or any other part of the synthesizer you liked to create this movement.